Elvis, there's a story I have to tell to the world that's never been told before. Elvis, one rainy, hot summer night here in Nashville about 7 or 8 years ago, what you did for me will always be a part of my life forever, as you will be for millions. You see, I was sitting on the back steps of RCA's Studio B that hot summer night, I guess trying to get out of the rain, not knowing it was you inside the studio recording. When some man opened the door and I stood up, and he asked me if I would go after some candy bars. I guess maybe he thought I worked there as a cleanup boy or something, but I really didn't. When I got back to the studio door, the candy bars in the paper bag was wet, and so was I. You see, I hadn't had a car for about 6 years. I knocked on the door, and the same man let me in. Then I heard a voice ask that I bring the candy bars into the studio. When I saw it was you that I got the candy bars for, I became very weak all over. I guess it was too much for a poor boy and a nobody like me to be bringing candy bars to a king like you. I remember you asked me my name and shook my hand and thanked me. And then you reached in your pocket and gave me a $20 bill and said, "Here, I want you to have this." You never did know it, Elvis, but that $20 bill, I guess in a big way, saved my life. You see, I'd been sleeping in the back of an old wrecked station wagon just up from the studio for about 11 days with only change in my pocket. And to be honest, I really hadn't eaten for almost 2 days. I never did see you again after that, but I want the whole world to know, if they don't already, the many little and big things you did for many people, such as myself. Elvis, I only wish I could have the chance again today to run to that same little store in the rain to get you some more candy bars.